Hey yo, what's up, ladies and gentlemen? This is ParOwner, and today we're here with another Hypixel Skyblock video. And in today's video, we are going to be actually teaching you how to make portals and how to actually destroy them. So I hope you guys are excited for today's video. Also, if you're new to the channel, please do subscribe with the notifications on, because I'm doing daily uploads and daily streams. And also, at 60 likes or more, I'm going to be uploading the next Hypixel video. So I hope you guys are excited for it. And if you do have any suggestions, what would you like to see in the future episodes, then just feel free to comment down below. But anyways, without further ado, let's just jump right into today's episode, and here we go. Okay guys, so I think we should get the video started by showing how to actually craft the portals, and then I'm gonna be showing you how to place them down correctly, and if you do misplace it, then how to actually destroy it. Because for instance, this portal right here to the deep caverns, as you guys can see, I accidentally placed it a little bit wrong, and the warp says that it's over here, and I wanted to switch the sides of it. And then we have this one which is correctly placed, and also I did misplace it a little bit. So we need to fix that, and I'm gonna be showing you guys this in a little bit. But first, we're gonna show you guys how to actually craft them, and it's very, very simple. So first off, oh my god, this spider came out of nowhere. But first of all, the deep caverns portal is super, super simple one. So you need to get your diamond level to 3, and in order to craft it, you just need to have lapis blocks, redstone blocks, and then enderpearls in the middle, and there you go, you got the deep caverns portal. Then, for instance, how to make a blazing fortress one is also very simple. Let me just go ahead and grab the materials. So you will need netherrack, and then you will also need nether bricks, and then once again enderpearls, and always you need 5 enderpearls for all the portals. Yeah, so there you go. Now there's actually a couple of more recipes that I don't have actually unlocked. So one of them is, like, for instance, Mushroom Island, where you need 15 cocoa beans, 5 enderpearls, and 25 cactus. And then the forest one, where you would need, like, I think 64 wood and 5 enderpearls. And that's as simple as that. And I believe if you want to have, like, birch warp, then you can have with the birch wood, etc, etc. But I myself, I only use 3 portals. I feel like I don't need the other ones, because the other ones are not that necessary for me, because I do spend most of the time at the deep caverns and blazing fortress. So for instance, if I do need to go to the gold mine, I would just go to deep caverns, and then all I would do is run backwards, and that's how we arrive to the gold mine. I feel like we don't need a portal for gold mine because of these reasons. Now, of course, we're going to be losing a little bit of time while flying, but to get to the deep caverns and running back, you will get directly to the gold mine teleportation. And the same goes for the blazing fortress, and that's why I only use 3 portals in total. One is for the hub, deep caverns, and also the blazing fortress, like I just mentioned. Now, actually, to place them, you do need a little bit of space, because they can take a lot of space. Let me go ahead and show you guys how to place it down. So for instance, you need actually about 5 blocks in total as a row. So for instance, if we go ahead and place it here, there needs to be 2 space here, 2 space here, and I believe 1 space over there and 1 space over there. So let's go ahead and place it down, for instance, right here for the sake of this video. Bam. And okay, some blocks are on the way. Maybe this blocks. Maybe it is actually a little bit larger on this side, but you guys are gonna see this. And as you guys can see, this is our blazing fortress. So I just realized that you actually need a little bit more space than 5, so that's my bad. But you need actually 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 spaces, and then the middle point is here, so it's like at the middle. And yeah, but let's say you want to destroy this portal because you misplaced it, like as you guys can see. I mean, who the heck places it on our little bridge here? So in order to do that, you do /break portal. And then you go ahead and get yourself a water bucket, and then you just place it here, and it starts destroying your little portal. And it's as simple as that. It doesn't really take too long to break it, and you know, you have to mine up the rest. And if you guys are wondering where can I get myself a water bucket, and you're new to the server, you can actually go down to your island, and then there's a chest at the very bottom which has a water bucket. So that's where you can get a water bucket as well. But anyways, let's go back to the top, and let's actually destroy this portal here, and let's destroy it all the way. So I think the middle point is going to be a little bit harder for us to destroy, because there's no blocks here. So we need to actually build some blocks around. I think this is the fastest strategy to do it. I think there can be also other strategies, but anyways, let's go ahead and do it. Also, this warp thingy was blocking it a little bit, so you just go around it. And it's as simple as that, and the rest you just mine up, and that's all you gotta do. And it's as simple as this to break the portal. Now, you do have to keep in mind the command break portal. This is something that they recently added, and during my live stream when they just added the portals, I did build this a little bit wrong, and that time I couldn't actually fix it. But now they added it, so you can actually go ahead and destroy it with the water bucket and with the command of break portal. Because if you don't have the break portal command on, then as you guys can see, it won't actually do anything, as you guys can see. So anyways, you do need to have the break portal command in order to do that, so just keep that in mind, and it's as simple as that. Alrighty, but now I'm gonna go ahead and place down the deep caverns portal so I can show you guys how to place them nicely next to each other. So instead of actually two blocks, you go 1, 2, 3, and then on the fourth one, you do want to place it down. Let's make sure that it's in the middle. There we go, and bam, and oh my god, oh my god. Alright, well, that was a little bit of a fail. I got too excited and I didn't check what's behind me, but there we go. We got the deep caverns portal, we got the blazing fortress portal, and it's working nicely, and it does look much better that you can finally destroy the portals, because that was something that you couldn't do at first until recently they added the command. But anyways, this is actually freaking amazing. I really love that they finally added the portals, because as you guys know, I have been spending so many hours literally running, because to get to the deep caverns, it takes a while, okay? Let me just show you guys how long it takes me. And I'm wearing right now a fairy set, which gives us extra speed. But let me just show you guys how fast or how long it actually takes us to get to the deep caverns. So first, you're gonna be running through the coal mine. Then you're gonna be getting to the gold mine. Dudes, honestly, these portals are lifesavers. Like, you save so much freaking time. You don't have to anymore go through all these distances to get to your final destination, because, like I said, most people actually spend most of the time in the deep caverns instead of the gold mine. You can actually see that by the lobbies, that the lobbies are often smaller in here than inside of the deep caverns, because, you know, that does offer like literally everything that you need. So anyways, here we are, we just arrived, and it took us a while, okay? That took us a while, especially if you don't have any speed armor or anything like this, it's gonna take you even longer. But now we can just simply go through the portal, and that's as simple as that. But I do hope you guys enjoyed today's video. Today's video was a quick little tutorial. I did want to clarify this, because I've been asked this during my live stream so many times, and I have repeated myself 1,000,000 times. I hope this video helped you, and honestly, go for these portals at least. You may want to get yourself a forest warp and mushroom island warp as well, but these are just my personal preferences, and these are portals good enough for me. And why do I keep jumping off? Why do I keep jumping off? But I do hope you guys enjoyed today's video. If you guys did, make sure you guys hit that like button. Anyways, thank you so much for watching. I hope to see you guys in the next one. Today's video was a little bit shorter, but I'm working on something insane. It's gonna be dropping tomorrow. Anyways, thank you so much for watching, guys. See you next time. Oh, I don't have enough mana. RIP. Anyways, bye-bye.